Hello, everybody, and welcome back to sunny California here. Welcome to the NASCAR Amino iRacing Cup Series, race number 2 here from the Auto Club, 2 Mile Superspeedway. I'm joined in the booth by, hey, you're new, Brad Pastor. How you doing?
I am doing great. Thank you, Tyler. I'm excited to be here today. And, you know, you mentioned Superspeedway on accident, but I'd say you were pretty on the nose with that one. This place is as close as you're going to get. Very fast 2 mile racetrack here in Southern California. A lot of speed, a lot of lines to take. I'm excited to see what these drivers are going to have for us today.
I am too. I think we're going to be in for a good show. Hopefully as good as a show as we had for the race last year. Well, on pole today, Justin Ricci put it on pole with a 41.154. Rap Bastard, why don't you take us through a lap here at Auto Club?
Yeah, and that's the beautiful thing about a track like this. There's so many different approaches that you can take to these corners, this racetrack. Justin here, he'll be just about at a middle line of the racetrack, dips it a bit low going into turn two, and the car sweeps up the racetrack down the backstretch. Again, really a lot of approaches. You have a lot of freedom here. So many grooves, so many ways that you can take this track. Here he'll take a bit of a higher entry. And once again, dip it right down low toward turn four. Just got to try to get that apex of the corner. You're not going to get much of a better lap than that. So Justin Ricci, somebody who definitely knows his way around these big racetracks, especially one like this here in Auto Club.
Yeah, he did. A really fast lap for him today. Well, we got to take a look at the rest of the starting grid. So let's take a look at that, and then we'll head down to pit room. Cars are lined up here on pit road. Let's head down trackside for the command.
Drivers, start your engine!
Cars are rolling off of pit road, ready to get this race underway. But before we get officially underway, let's head down to pit road for some late breaking news.
One guy to look out for today is that 15 machine with Caleb Marinelli behind the wheel. He absolutely loved racing last year, and even though he saw the wind slip away from him, he's feeling very confident. You know, I asked him why he tends to run well at these big, fast intermediates, and he said there's so many lanes to choose from. He knows what went wrong last year, and he knows how to improve. Anything less than a top five is a disappointment to him. Someone, though, who doesn't have a ton of confidence is Caleb's teammate Anthony Sasso. Sure, he qualified top 10, but he was not pleased with it. He was shocked to learn how much speed they had, because the car just wasn't to his liking. He described the car as, quote, jumpy, and he said if he makes one small mistake, he's afraid the car's going to come out from him. He's going to hope that the changes that they made overnight is going to help him out in the long run, too.
Thank you, Dan, once again on pit road. But here's a quick race analysis. 50 laps, 28 to 32 lap fuel window, 3 sets of tires or so, and Caleb Marinelli was the practice winner. So, who you got winning this thing? I think it should be a good one here.
You know, I've been looking at that 15 car, but I don't know. I don't think they get it together quite yet. I'm going to go with the 8 of Zach Stern. That Ally machine is always fast, and I think he's going to bring this one home today. It's a packed crowd here. I hope these fans are excited as I am to get this thing going.
I hope they are, too. That's a good pick, and we are ready to get this race underway. Justin Ricci, Caleb Marinelli lead him to the green flag. We are underway here at Auto Club. Side by side entering turn one. Marinelli with a slight nose ahead. They're going to be side by side into turn one. 3 wide already behind them. They're even looking to go 4 wide already.
And here in Fontana, they fan out so quickly. Go way more than 2 wide, usually 3 wide. Sometimes they'll even go 4 right off the bat. Not quite here. Already here comes the 15 trying to come down battle the 12 car Justin Ricci for the lead.
He's going to make that look really easy. 3-4 wide behind him already. Dylan Jones sliding back a little bit. Evan Toddy trying to find ground as well. Alan Mooch with a really good start so far. But up front, it's Caleb Marinelli leading lap number one.
That 15 car usually good at getting up front early on here at this track. We'll see if he can hold on to it today and finally find victory lane. A lot of Chevrolets up here toward the front.
Oh, Zach Stern already trying to go to the inside. Marinelli thinking of blocking a little bit here. It's a little bit interesting to start here. Stern not much of a run. Marinelli going to send it deep into turn three. Stern a little bit of a drive off, but it's not going to be enough.
Yeah, and he'll probably get the run right here, try to get to the inside. We'll see if it can pay off for him going into turn one. A few Tau teammates right there behind the 8 car, trying to catch up to this top two.
Stern with a slight nose ahead. He's going to send it into turn one. Is he going to be able to get clear? He's going to try a little slide job move. Going to get a little bit of a nose ahead. Not quite clear. Now he is. Stern to the lead early.
Surprised me how quickly he was able to make that move. Usually it'll take you a lap or two to fully be able to clear somebody, but Stern does it with absolute ease. And now he's got a few teammates coming in that are going to help him, but now here's owner of Brink, Caden Bishop, coming through for four.
Yeah, we're already seeing a lot of team variety. I wouldn't say much team variety, honestly. We have two
Brink. It's Brink and Tau all over.
I was going to say, it's Brink, and then there's five Tau cars, or no, not five, four Tau cars, and then you have the Omaki car of Nate Wines there. Just barely peeking as here goes Marinelli for the lead.
Back down low, the owner of the 15 car, Caden Bishop, is also coming on through. He wants a piece of this race lead.
Already in the
they're
back.
They're five wide in the back, my God.
Yeah, they are. JD looks like he has a little bit of damage on the right side. We're going to be getting to the wall a little bit. Not even a good start at all for that machine. Oh my God. Oh, Paul Donlin. That's another driver. I'm already surprised. Look at these drivers in the back. James, Paul, and JD. Surprising that they seem to be really, really struggling early.
Yeah, and that 7 car didn't have the most speed last week. A track like this is somewhere where he's definitely got to try to turn that around so he can have the same, if not a better season than he had last season, nearly winning the championship.
Side by side already, it's Brink versus Tau up front. You got the Brink cars on the bottom working together, and you got the Tau cars also up top. Oh, it looks like Stern's going to get just barely ahead of Caden Bishop. A little bit of a block there. Now here comes Carter into the mix.
It looked like they were starting to form tandems there, but then the 37 and 15 broke off. The 8 went down low. Now they're 3 wide for second. Stern's in trouble here.
Marinelli has a little bit of a run there. He had a little bit of help from Carter there in 4th place. Caleb's going to try to send it. Oh, it looks like he's going to be able to clear. Here comes Caden. Oh, 3 wide back here. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, and you even see Brink and Tau back here.
It's actually a good bit of variety up here a little bit. Now you have the new team with Ethan O'Connor up here. You have Amaki up here. And then you have Alan Mooch with the new Neon Surge Racing up here as well, trying to find his way, just barely in the top 10.
Carter Jones up here in third. Tau so far showing their dominance. And that 62 car, that's somebody who desperately wants to find victory lane in the series and has had the speed to do so, but very similar to that 15 car, hasn't been able to put it together.
Caleb slides up just a little bit there. That stalls the run for Carter here. Trying to figure out where to go on the inside. It's helping Zach pull away just a little bit here. Now here comes Nate to the mix.
Yeah, and that 8 certainly won't be pulled away for long. You got a lot of guys back here pushing. Draft is pretty big here in Fontana, and it's pretty difficult to pull away.
Yeah, remember how you said it in pre-race, how kind of I mistakenly said it? This is kind of a little bit of a pack race here. Looks how really, really important the draft is here. This is about the top 11, 12 cards up here in this draft.
It definitely can be a super speedway, and you think it would be with the speeds that these cars are reaching constantly. Tracks like this and also Michigan, which we will be racing at later in the season. But, you know, not quite considered a super speedway, but, I mean, again, one could beg to differ. You see the racing we have here, it's kind of a mixed bag. You never really know what you're going to get at Auto Club, but we're definitely getting something very similar to what you'd see at Daytona and Talladega here today. Not quite as bumper to bumper as they would be at those tracks, though.
Yeah, it's not as insane as it was last week at Daytona, but we are. This is probably about the closest we're going to get. As Marinelli back to the inside of Zach Stern, I will say this racing has been incredible so far. I love how all these cars can just maneuver all over the place as Carter's going to go three wide up the middle.
And there is no dominant line whatsoever. You can run anywhere and try to get the advantage. The track changes over the course of the race. Oh, here comes Ethan O'Connor now finding his way into the mix.
Carter is going to be able to clear. He jumps to the bottom in front of Caleb there, and he's going to jump right back up in front of his Tau teammate. But Carter Jones today is going to lead laps for the first time and get that extra bonus point. That's something else we haven't noted very much. Leading laps, bonus points right there. You're going to want those.
Something that a lot of these drivers are going to need, especially the ones who have yet to find victory lane and might not find victory lane this season. Those bonus points are going to be vital toward the championship.
Three wide back here. Caden up top, Tanner in the middle. Ethan O'Connor showing up front here. It's three wide, two rows back here. And Marinelli's back to the inside of Carter Jones. Easily takes the lead. Stern slides up a little bit. Oh, my.
And that's another thing about Auto Club. They seem to never not be three wide. Constantly at this track, they are fanning out so wide just with all the lanes that we have here to offer.
New name, Anthony Sasso's broken into the top five for the first time today. That's three Brink cars now in the top five. Two Tau Racing cars, Tanner and Carter there as well, as they're going to go single file here. They're going to try to form up a run, as here goes Carter thinking about it. Oh, here he goes. Maybe.
Yeah, and you see that line won't last for long. You saw both the 62 and 37 swerving back and forth to see, wow, close race between the 62 and 15. Trying to see if they wanted to duck out or not, and ultimately they decide to.
Good move there by Caden Bishop. Goes up high with his teammate there. Going to move both of them into the top two here as we're flying by in this race. 12 laps in already. Pit road. Not quite there yet, but we will be there in about 20 laps. Nate Wines almost contact with Carter there. Nate moved to third.
And there's a Ford appearance. That's our defending champion, Evan Toddy, right there in the 32 car. First time I've seen him up here toward the top five today.
And now we're starting to have a little bit of variety here. Nate here in third, Tanner to the inside, Evan there in the top five, Anthony Sasso just behind there in sixth. Double wide here. Tanner trying to find a way on the bottom. Evan's going to go with Nate here.
Really colorful battle right there for third between the 24 and 38 cars.
Oh, here we go for the lead. Brink teammates up front. Caleb on the high side. Caden slides up. Almost contact. Oh, sideways. Caden really tight there. Almost got into the door of his teammate.
And these guys aren't going to hold back when racing each other. I mean, Caden Bishop and all the guys at Brink have stated it several times. As soon as they get on track, they are no longer teammates. They're all racing for themselves. They're obviously still a team, but it's made up of individual teams, and that's how they race. That's how they compete. They try to push each other to the absolute limit so that everybody on the team can be their best.
And they had that aggressive move. Remember back to Watkins Glen last year when Caden Bishop made that pass of, like, five cars in one corner? Yeah, Caden Bishop.
Yeah, you can't forget it.
No, Caden Bishop will do anything to get positions.
Yeah, and he'll race that 24 car the same as he would race that 15 car.
Tanner.
Evan Toddy trying to get up here now.
Tanner, a little bit of a run here. He's going to peek to the inside. Caden's going to run that seam right there. He's going to run the middle. Tanner going to see if he can go anywhere. Where does Caleb decide to go? Does he go with Tanner? Or does he go with his teammate? Looks like he's going to go with his teammate. Oh, never mind. Oh, he does stay up top.
He decides to help the teammate there. I think that's probably the more popular move there, but probably won't be staying behind him for long.
Oh, Tanner to the inside, trying to get in front of Caden. Not much help from Evan right now. He's a little bit behind. Tanner peeking way to the inside. There goes Evan's help. He goes to the top now. Caden's going to surge ahead to the lead with his teammate right behind him.
Brink's starting to really take over Tau Racing for the most part in terms of this battle for the lead. Marinelli's ducking low.
So much for teamwork. Oh, he's going to go for the lead. Oh, that may have been actually a very smart move. If he can pull this off here in turn one. No, Tanner sends it way deep and is going to hold it. Evan, almost into the door of Caleb
way
there. Caleb way down low here. He's going to allow them to go three wide, it looks like. Yeah, Evan's going to go up the middle.
He's going to duck behind this 37 car. Oh, 15 almost up into the 32.
Oh, that would have been bad. That would have been bad. But Evan, it looks like he's going to barely clear Caleb. Yes, he does. As this has allowed Tanner to pull away just a little bit, but they are still three wide, four wide behind him. Oh, Justin and Carter, almost contact. Anthony Sasso up top trying to find a way to go. Nate Wines is going to be right behind him. Here comes Alan Mooch going to go in. Oh, he's going to go in between the 26 and the 8.
Yeah, very intrigued to see how Neon Surge Racing is going to perform this year. Yet another organization for Chevrolet to be brought in. Alan Mooch with a good showing today.
A little bit further in the back, there's Kyler Sustry, who had that level L1 penalty last week. He's going to look for a little rebound. There's Daytona winner Alex Muriel not doing as good as he probably wants. James Omaki back here still. Paul Donlin, JD. Still in the very last pack here, that this is probably not at all what they wanted from today.
Yeah, definitely not. You're not going to have all these guys having good days all together like you can at Daytona. There were so many lead changes in that race, so many comers and goers. It's just not going to be the same here at Auto Club.
I will say, though, we have had a good bit of lead changes here today. Is Caden going to send it once again on Tanner? We have had quite a lot of lead changes, I will say, for Auto Club.
We certainly have. The only difference being it's a very similar group of cars as we've had most of the race so far.
Let's put it this way. We've had a lot of lead changes, but not many different leaders.
Yes, that is very true. We got some drivers back here we haven't quite seen up front today. I saw the 5 of Leland 5 back there, another Omaki car. Man, there are a lot of those Omaki cars.
I know, right? How many of them are there? 7 or so? And there's only
something
what?
Like that. It's like there's a new one every day.
I know, and there's only what? 2 of them up here? Probably not at all what they want. We're gonna go on board here with Tanner here. See if he's gonna let's see what line he takes here to see to try and steal the lead away from Caden. Get a good run in this trial.
Taking a little bit of a lower line than him. But he's not going to be carrying as much speed as that 37.
He's going to really need to depend on that draft. He immediately jumps up right behind him. Going to get a little bit of draft here. Getting very, very close. Getting there. Let's see if he can what he can do in turn three here. Sends it deep.
Oh, that might that right draft might have helped him out there, but he's not going to be able to quite get to him.
Let's see. They're side by side right now. It's going to be close at the line. It looks.
And all that battling's going to allow the 15 to come on.
Who's he go with? Does he go with his teammate? Or does he abandon Caden once again? He stays up top. Oh, he's taking a middle line, though. But
I was thinking for a second he was going to go neither, but then that door closed up pretty quickly.
Yeah, I don't know. I find this racing between the 15 and the 37 is really interesting. It's like they help each other at times, but then they just don't care.
Yeah, if you were just a casual viewer, you couldn't tell that they were teammates. But they certainly are.
As we come up here to lap 22, nearing halfway in this race. Again, flowing by very quickly. Not any incidents today. Which I will say these drivers are known for. These drivers keep their cars clean fairly often, as pit window will be opening very soon. As here comes Ethan O'Connor. Haven't mentioned
him. Yeah, into the picture, that 28 car. He got a massive run on the front straightaway. It's now going right through the middle of the Brink Toyotas.
Can he go for the lead? He's got him enough of a run. Can he get to Tanner? It's going to be close. Oh, he gets tight. And here comes a 15 down low again.
Oh, and he's through the middle again, but now it's through the sucker hole. That 15 has a big run off the corner.
Wow, what a move that was by Caleb there. Now here comes Carter. After that slow corner by the Ethan O'Connor has allowed Carter to come into the mix.
And all that battling
trying as well.
Here comes the stampede.
See, it's like these guys are getting separated, but at the same time, just one slip up, and then they're right back into the group.
Yeah. That 24 is definitely not safe either, but these brink cars have, oddly enough, been doing a good job at keeping him the race leader, keeping everybody else behind. But now here comes a teammate in the 62.
I'm trying to think who has the dominant car today, and I will say that 24 is really, really fast. I'm pretty sure he's led the most laps up to this point. I could be wrong, but it sure feels like he's led the most today. Carter's going to finally peak to second. Caleb thinking of going three wide? Is he? No, he backs out.
He backs out, but he's going to be taken three wide instead by this 32 card. More close racing with our defending champion.
Again, I will say this may not be like Daytona last week, but the racing we are having today, this is incredible. I love what these
just
drivers
as excited
are able to do. Look at that cloud cover that just covered turn three and four there. I find that interesting because all of a sudden, probably in the mere seconds, cars will all of a sudden have their grip back.
Yeah, the fans probably appreciate it too with that hot California sun going behind the clouds, at least for a brief moment of time. It's a bit toasty down here in Fontana.
Yeah, it is. It's a little bit. Ethan O'Connor got a little loose there. Three wide. Justin Ricci's going to go up the middle. Oh, now they're three wide. Two rows back. Justin, looks like he checked up a little bit.
Yeah, and welcome back to the picture. Zach Stern in the 8 car. The 5 of Leland Fife is also making his way up here.
I will say, this has actually been a relatively quiet day for Zach Stern. Like you picked him pre-race, I expected a little bit more speed, but it seems like he's just running mid-6th, 7th place this whole race.
Yeah, no doubt in my mind he will get back up there, though, as he's doing right now. We've reached the midway point of this race. So I'd imagine the pit window will be opening relatively shortly.
Yeah, I'm going to say pit road will be open. I'm going to guess within the next 5 laps or so, 3, 4, 5 laps maybe. 3 wide.
Oh, is Marinelli
going to
take
it more?
Oh,
he thought about it. Doesn't look like
he's
enough of a draft.
Not quite. No help down low, at least for that moment.
I will say, man, look at that 8 car. That thing just looks so tight. He can't send it into the corner like he wants to. Got really tight against Ethan O'Connor, and now Caden Bishop peeking to the inside, Leland Fife looking to the outside.
All his battling is letting the top two pull away just a little bit. We'll see how long that lasts.
Yeah, we'll see who decides to peel the pit road first. I imagine whoever comes in first, next lap, more people are going to come in. Tanner's all by himself here. Like I said, I think he is probably the car to beat today. He's been out front the most. He's had a lot of speed. But that 62 is going to try to give him a run for his money.
I think that 24 car is definitely becoming the class of the field as this race goes by. We'll see if pit strategy can help him any.
Pit road.
Definitely a good day for tower racing.
Yes, definitely a good day for tower racing. Brink having a couple cars up there. Omaki sneaking into the picture just a little bit. Here comes Leland. He's going to be able to clear Zach. Puts himself in the top 5. Here goes Caden up the middle.
I don't know if I agree with him sliding down here. It's going to allow everybody else up top to absolutely freight train this 5 car.
Up front, the battle for the lead's gotten closer. Carter's going to send it way up high. Tanner's going to run the way by. Is he pitting? Yeah, here he comes.
Yes,
down pit road. Leader down pit road first. How will that affect things? He's the only one down pit road right now.
I'd imagine we'll see some, if not all, of the rest of the field come down next time by. Really interesting to see the 24 be the only one that goes down right there on lap 28.
Let's see if Carter Jones' teammates can bring it in here next time by. He's got Ethan O'Connor right behind him now in second place. Double wide, two rows behind them. peeking to the inside. I wonder if that's their indication to pit road.
And this will likely be it right here. They're going way low.
Yeah, let's see. Looks like both of them are going to pit here. Ethan Carter bringing it today. Carter's not pitting.
Carter does not.
Is that what you call a trick move? He indicated he's pitting and he wasn't? Who else is that? The Brink cars? Caden and Caleb bringing in as well?
I do believe so. It's mostly Chevrolets that have yet to go down.
Either way, that was... I don't know if that was planned or not, but Carter just tricked a lot of them to pit and then didn't.
If that was planned, he deserves quite the award for that. He tricked even us here in the booth that he was going down, running the exact line as O'Connor.
I think he's going to bring it on pit road as well. His teammate Zach's going to look like he's going to bring it in as well here. Evan showing no indication he's pitting this lap. Yep, here comes Carter, Zach, Nate, Leland, and Sasso all on pit road. Who's left? Evan Toddy, Justin Ricci, yet to pit. I imagine they're going to bring it in this lap. I don't really see how they can run any longer, honestly. Pit window's got to be closed any lap now. Here comes a 15 off of pit road. They're going to merge off and put him a lap down, but it's probably not going to say. It looks like they're pitting. Both of them are pitting.
Yeah, they should be right here, and it looks like the teams aren't really connected in strategy. It seems to be really all over the place. Very interesting there.
Yep, here comes the 32 and the 12 onto pit road. We'll see if they are the last ones. Here comes Alan Moosh to pit road. Kyler Sustry does not pit. Interesting.
And in the past, we've seen this strategy work in the worst way possible.
What the heck just happened? I just saw smoke out of the 78. They look slower. They out of fuel.
I was just going to mention, we've had things happen in the past, but the strategy has not played out, and we've seen these cars run out of fuel before getting to pit road.
We saw this last year. Remember Zach Stern, Justin Ricci did the same exact strategy?
Something very similar, very baffling move. Seems a similar thing might have happened to a driver who had a penalty he certainly did not need. Not the way you'd like the season to start for Kyler Sustry, Seth Peters as well. Not in a spot that you'd like to be in.
Quinn as well. These three drivers tried to push it. Maybe an extra lap. Doesn't look like they can go any. I don't think they're going to make it. This might bring out a yellow. Bam, right there.
And Sustry did make it down, but the 78 and 29 did not.
Quinn is going to be just short. Oh, so short. That cycle is Tanner Campos back to the lead once again. Peters is short of pit road as well. Trying to nurse it, just not enough. There's the field as they cycle through. Sustry is stopped on pit road. Oh, was he just short? Couldn't make it to his box. Ouch.
And we'll see how this lines everything up.
I believe that is everybody else. Yep, everybody else off pit road. So let's see. Tanner Campos, Ethan O'Connor, Caden Bishop, Evan Toddy, Carter Jones is your new top five. Seth is still parked. Kyler is still parked. And Quinn is probably parked as well. Unless he got pushed off. So here is your order. Tanner will be the leader. Unless they decide to pit again for some reason, but I don't see a reason why.
Connor seems to be low.
Let's see, I wonder if that's a fake call. Does not look like they are pitting. Nope. Doesn't look like anybody's pitting.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's going down.
Nobody in the back either. Paul Donlin bringing it in. James as well. Jordan Fox.
Quite a few
Wild,
of them,
JD.
Actually.
Well, we're going to head to break after this interesting pit call here, this caution right now. We're going to see this message, and then we'll be back for the green.
I lift my heart, a spring lifts up, a yellow daisy to the rain. My heart will be a lovely cup, although it holds but pain. For I shall learn from flower and leaf that color every drop they hold. to change the lifeless wine of grief to living gold.
All right, everybody, welcome back to Auto Club. We are getting ready to go back green flag racing after a caution involving, well, you see those two back there, Seth Peters, Quinn Yeager, and Kyler Sustry, who all tried an alternate strategy, but did not work. They ran out of fuel on the racetrack, in the middle of the racing grooves, could not get out of the way, and that brought out the yellow flag. So, that means up front we have Tanner Campos, Ethan O'Connor on the front row, and it's Caden Bishop, Evan Toddy, Carter Jones, and Leland Fife in your first three rows. Gonna go back green here. Not many laps to go. We're definitely gonna have under 20 laps to go. How do you think this is gonna shape out here?
This is where we really get down to the nitty gritty here. We'll see if this field can keep up with that 24 car. He has proven to be the fastest one out here.
Here they come to the restart zone. Tanner's gonna fire off. Green flag back in the air. And Caden peeking low. Evan peeking high. But they cannot take it anywhere as we only have 15 laps to go. Dead even into turn two. O'Connor with the surge up top. He's going to maybe be able to clear Tanner Campos as they are three wide behind him now.
The 37 move low. That's definitely not going to be the move that he needed. But here comes his teammate Anthony Sasso into the picture. Getting really close. Four wide here. Off turn four.
Oh my goodness. Two Brink cars in the middle. That's Leland Carter up in the top and the bottom. Three, I think there's still four wide back there. Carter losing all sorts of momentum.
They could go five if they wanted to, but I think they're a bit smarter than that. But yeah, we knew they'd get aggressive late in this race.
Oh man, all the momentum being lost. Oh, Paul Don Lindo sideways almost takes out Roberto Crown Jr. there. But they ultimately keep it straight as it's still a battle for the lead. Evan Toddy's moved to second place. They have forced Tanner back to third.
They're starting to train just a little bit. I'd imagine this won't last for long. Already, here comes the 32 going down. And he'll have two other drivers try to come down. Tanner's thinking he might go middle.
Oh, come on, Tanner. Do it. Go up the middle. He goes up the middle.
He's going middle. Tanner Campos.
Oh, and he gets the nose ahead. Here comes Leland.
Here comes Leland Fife.
Wow. Now, okay. Remember what you said? Now it's down to, like, the nitty-gritty?
Yes.
Very much now. Now we have a couple new players. Leland up here, barely outside the podium. Anthony Sasso's peeking his name up into the picture now as well. Oh, Evan Luce on the bottom.
Yeah, that 32 has been all over the racetrack all race long, getting really close to all the cars that get near him. But once again, Tanner Campos with a move that might have just won him this race, but we still have over 10 laps to go.
It's going to be interesting. Being the leader is not the best place you want to be, but it's definitely a good start. Tanner's led a lot of laps today, but he hasn't led every single one. As here comes Ethan underneath. Ethan looking for his first ever. Look at how many drivers up here looking for some of their first wins. Ethan, Leland, Justin Ricci, all three of them looking for their first win.
And that 24 not able to pull away. This 28 has shown that he is here to win. So is that 5 car.
Oh, he might go three wide.
Trying to make it two in a row for James Omaki and his 7 car powerhouse.
Leland to the inside looking for the lead. Could this be a good move? Tanner sends it on the outside. Oh, they get tight underneath him. Oh, it looks like he's going to be able to clear. Here comes Sasso to the picture.
Sasso trying to be Toyota's savior for a race that has seemingly gotten away from them, but he's got his two teammates not far behind.
Oh, three wide still back here. Zach Stern trying to get back into the picture for the win here. He's going to draft with Leland. That 5 car seems to be really fast as well. Here comes Justin Ricci. I feel like we've barely mentioned his name today. He's been at the back of this lead pack all day, and now all of a sudden he's up to second.
And it's surprising for somebody who put down such a blistering lap in qualifying for him to not be up there. They are four wide off turn two.
Oh my goodness. They are going to barely make it hold, I think. Is anyone going to give? No one's showing they're going to give. Oh, they're going to go into the corner four wide. Carter looks like he's going to give. Here comes Dylan Jones into the picture now.
These drivers given as little as they can here at the Auto Club Speedway. Justin Ricci has taken the race lead away. And now here's Caden Bishop all of a sudden.
Caden was so fast earlier. And now, then he just like slowed down. And now he's back up front here. Did Tanner Campos just, I don't know, did he just find a way to let this wind slide away? Never mind, no he didn't. Here he comes back to the outside.
He is still here, and I don't think he'll be leaving anytime soon. We're going to see this big pack of cars up here battling for the win as we get down to it.
Tanner surges back to the lead here. Ethan O'Connor is going to try and fight the 12 car for second place here. Cade Bishop's going to think of going three wide. He's going to do it. Leland's going to drive on the outside. Caleb finding a way to go. They may go four wide. No, they don't.
15 was going to go down with his teammate, but the run was just not there as he resorts to the outside, now middle lane.
You know what? I never thought of this, but these lead cars, Tanner Campos is the only driver that has won. Look at all these names that are going to try and get their first win. I don't even know how crazy this might get here. Here comes
it's early in the season, but there's a lot of desperation. All these drivers are definitely no secret to that fact.
There's so many that are trying to get there. Do you think they're going to try and team up on Tanner here?
Probably. Mainly to help themselves out. Because if they don't team up, there's going to be no way they get up there.
I mean, look how many there are. There's Caleb, there's Leland, there's Justin, there's Ethan O'Connor, Nate, Caden, Carter. That's seven names I just listed in the top eight that are looking for their first win.
And there's been nobody closer to getting that first win without getting it in that 15 car. And he is going to try to battle Campos for this race lead.
Oh, he's going to go to the inside. It's close there. This is allowing Leland to come into the picture now. Caleb on the inside. Trying to poke the nose ahead. Who does Leland go with? Oh, he goes with Tanner.
And they got to keep that 24 at base so that he doesn't pull away. 15 did a good job of that there as the pack catches back up. The 5 going with his Chevrolet-affiliated teammate. And now the 15 has no help down low.
I was going to say, there are four Chevys in the top 5 here. Caleb, the lone Toyota. But all four on that outside, all Chevrolets. Here goes Leland. He's been close to winning a couple times, especially last season. He had two runner-ups, and now he's looking to turn that runner-up into a first win.
And they're leaving Tanner Campos out to dry now, at least for the moment. Oh, Campos going to be able to catch up to the 5 now. And Leland has a teammate up here now, the 38 of Nate Wines, into the top 5.
Justin Ricci to the inside, going for the lead. Leland sends it hard. He's going to hold the position. Justin's going to clear for second. Here comes Tanner to the outside of Caleb for third again.
Oh, Campos moving down low. That might help the 15 and a few guys toward the back.
Tanner going to send it deep. I'm wondering how, if that pit stop changed anything for the 24, because they were super fast early. They're fast now, but they're not able to lead as much. I wonder if it's just they made an adjustment on that pit stop that didn't work, or they just are finding themselves at the wrong place at the wrong time right now. Oh, he's thinking of going up the middle. He's thinking about it, but they close up the gap. He doesn't go anywhere. He's going to go with his teammate Ricci on the outside.
Tower Racing trying to overpower this 5 car, and now the 15 has a teammate right behind.
Oh, Ricci's
gonna he's going to take it 3 wide.
Oh, my. Oh, is this going to work? Oh, Caleb way up high. Caden and Leland almost touch. Caden sends it hard on the inside. They're going to be 3 wide off the 4. Oh, he checks up.
And we're back to where we started. It's Tower Racing. It's Brink battling for the win.
And we only have 3 laps to go. It's only 3 laps. That's like what? 18 turns? we still, like, 18, I can't math, but whatever, there's still a lot of drivers up here. I think any of these top four or five can win this race still.
Most definitely, and they're going to have to get a run. Right now, it's looking like this top four, it's going to be one of these guys that ends up getting it. They've been basically the class of the field all race long.
Caden up the middle. Is this going to go anywhere? This time by, it's only going to be two laps to go.
It's definitely going somewhere, and that somewhere is the bumper of this 12 car. They are three wide for second. And we'll see who's able to prevail from this.
Here, let me ask you this prediction. We have three of the four drivers in the top four that have not won. We have a 75% chance of getting a new winner. Do you think it's going to happen?
I think so. I couldn't tell you who. Anything could happen here, but I think it's so much more likely that we get that. But definitely don't count out this 24. He's trying to win the race right now.
He's been the fastest car all day. He's led the most laps today. He's sending it on the inside. Caleb's going to go to the outside. This time by, one lap to go. Richie's going to lead him.
And now this five car, he's trying to get himself back in the picture at the last second. Is he going to have the time? I don't know if anyone's going to catch the 12 car.
They're going to be side by side entering turn one. This is exactly what Justin Ricci wants to see. Down the backstretch for the final time. If Caleb or Tanner wants anything for this win, they got to clear each other now.
And the 15 has a run here. He might be the only one that's going to have a shot at the 12 car.
Here they go into turn three. Ricci stacks it up. Here comes Marinelli to the
inside.
He's going
down low.
Here he goes off of turn
four. Side by side.
Just like last year, it's going to be a photo finish.
He's not going to do it in time.
Oh, it's going to be
Justin
close.
Ricci.
Wow, what a finish. Just like last year, another photo finish. They'll finish it off, and Justin Ricci is going to get his first NASCAR Amino iRacing Cup Series victory. Wow, what a finish.
I don't really know what you can even say about that. I mean, what else could you have expected? And it was between Tao and Brink for the victory, as close as you can get. And from the pole, Justin Ricci and his Coca-Cola machine is going to burn this thing down.
You know, you could say from the pole, but Caleb and Justin started top two, and they finished top two.
They most certainly did. I forgot about that 15 car, but never count him out. Never count Justin Ricci out. He proved why he's here and why he's in a Tao Racing Chevrolet.
He was so close last year to winning a couple times, but finally, he has just managed to get that first career win. He's going to burn it down. I imagine he does not want to burn up this engine because that was a fast 12 car. I'll be honest, I didn't expect him to win this race early because he was like 8th place a lot of this race, but just after that caution, he's managed to find his way up front and he stayed there.
I knew he would always be in it. I was only doubting it mainly because of all the guys back there who were inevitably going to catch up to the 12 car. And you saw the 15. If he had one more lap, he most certainly would have had this race won, but that just wasn't the case. It's the 12 car who's going to bring this thing to victory lane here at Auto Club.
What an impressive victory. That is another win for Tao Racing. An impressive win by Justin Ricci to get his first one. He's going to park it in victory lane. Thank you, Rat Bastard, for joining me in the booth. Hopefully everybody enjoyed the race. And now let's take a look at the finishing results.